Wait, you gotta redraw the map.
We have a. We lived in a house in Lawndale, and our bedroom was in the back, and there was a hallway, and there was a bedroom here. This is Lisa's bedroom. And you walked down the hallway, and there was a bathroom. There was a washer, dryer, laundry room. When you came in through the, to the kitchen, there was a dining room here. Then you go back down the hallway past the living room. And Joey just couldn't sleep. He was crying. He would cry so hard, and he wouldn't stop. So I decided I'd walk him every night. So I'd, as we walked down the hall, I'm patting him on the back, and I said, "Woe is me, woe is me. Here we go into the dining room. We're back down the hallway, Joey. We're going back by the bedroom. Oh, here we are at the washer dryer again. Woe is me, woe is me. There's the refrigerator, there's the stove, there's the dining room. Woe is me." And then as I start looking at him, I start thinking he looked a lot like me, more than his mother. So I start saying, "Woes is me, woes is me, woes is me." And eventually I just dropped everything and just call him Woes.
Here we go. Of the snake, I'm my father's second son. 1977 marks the birth of Woes One, and the same place that I got my namesake from. Pop said I cried as an infant through the night, so he walked me around the house just to try and get me right. Singing little lullabies, wiping tears from my eyes. He was a hard-working middle-class man making time. Up and at him in the morning, off he'd go to work, making ends meet, seen through the sweat on his shirt. Traded drumsticks for paintbrushes that had to hurt, but he made his family the priority, coming first. Dinner on the table in our small little house, didn't have a whole lot, but we never went without. With the clothes on my back and the food in my mouth, when the kids call me poor, I didn't know what that's about. Cause I always had a home, and I always felt the love, dignity and pride. My father showed me what that was, told me hold my head high, followed that up with a hug. Then he let me know that he was very proud I was his son. This is for my father and to everything he's done, a musician and a mentor and a friend rolled into one. Nothing but respect from the day my life begun. Before I fell in love with hip hop, it all started with your drums.
I remember all my life.
Sadness. I remember being raised up at band practice. Drum kits, microphones, bass guitar, saxes. Brush strokes being added to a blank canvas. Your friends were like family, it dawned on me later. George Porch, Chuck Anthony, and Red Safer. Old school musicians back then known as players. The type of friendship that you know won't waver. I was just a child, so I didn't understand it. A life-changing seed in my soul had been planted. Little did I know it at the time, what would happen. Those were the very first roots of my passion. Learning from your music through my whole entire youth. I now understand the reason why you had a music room, writing song after song just to keep a piece of you after a long day of doing what you had to do. I understand the sacrifice you made for my life. I hope you know exactly what you gave me in life. It's all because of you. Thanks for saving my life. I try to repay it, living each day of my life. Lead by example and I'll follow your lead, standing strong on 2 feet to the sound of the beat. You gave me everything that I could ever need. You're the reason that the sleeve even reads "Woe Is Me." Woe Is Me.
I remember all my life.
Of a studio, songwriter, supervisor rates, working TV shows, union dues paid, full dental and medical. Moved out of Lawndale, heading to a newer home. We arrived in Claremont, man, it was culture shock. 12 years old, I had barely been off our block. House with a front and backyard, and that was a lot. 3 times bigger than our previous spot. You would drive to Hollywood every weekday. Moved up in the frame, and the feature films came. Per diem on location and a salary raise. But no matter about the pay, cause you always stayed the same. The measure of success that you reached is was unreal. You were fresh out of high school and had a record deal. Ran the course of that, switched to movie reel. I don't think that you can comprehend the pride that I feel. Perform with Richie Valens, perform with Sam Cooke. Had your name up on the big screen, you need to write a book. The pictures on the wall show the journey that you took. A story that's impressive to anyone that would look. Some people talk the talk and others just walk. I only know the difference cause your life I have watched. I hold the torch of the legacy you taught. My papa ain't a rolling stone, my father is a rock.
I remember all my life.
My name is Danny Hinzo. I'm the executive producer of Verbal Building. I'm also the executive producer of Woe Is Me. As a matter of fact, not only did I create Woes, but I named him. You're listening to Woe Is Me.